Dome Sports Talk, worldwide, with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, let's talk whatever weight, because it was a catch weight anyway. Welterweight guy that fought in a catch weight of 156, and that'll be Jeff Horn. Now, Jeff Horn took out your boy Anthony Mundane in one round, left hooked him. Got him up out of there. I think Mundane lost about 8 fights. But this is a rough guy. Been in some good fights. And it was the Battle of Australia. You know what I mean? And to take him out in one, you know, Mundane's getting up there in age, but he's a rough guy. You know, a talker. Very colorful character. And Jeff Horn is now the main man in Australia. Right? Go up from 147. Meet this guy at a catch weight of 156. Because Mundane has fought some fights at 160 before. You know, so... You know, this is a good win for Jeff Horn because of his devastating first round KO. Mundane now is gonna retire, right? So you know, that's cool. After all these fights, he's done his thing, like 48-8. It's time for him to get up out of there. But you know, this is just respect for Jeff Horn. You know, because Jeff Horn is somebody you know keep your eyes on. You know, he reminds me a lot of other fighters who are not so conventional. But they still handle their business, and they get a lot of hate. People try to act like they don't see what they do, because the people, if you don't do things conventionally and you do it your way, but still are successful, you might get a little hate. That's what happens. Now Jeff Horn, you know, he's famous for beating Manny Pacquiao, right? And then there was an outrage that he didn't beat Manny Pacquiao, and he did. No matter how you slice it, and because of the outrage, people went back. The judge went back, looked at it again, everybody got together again, and came up with the same thing. He beat Manny Pacquiao, right? Manny Pacquiao goes on to do great things, beat Lucas Matisse, right? About to fight Broner, right? So, and Jeff Horn comes and loses to Terrence Crawford. Smaller guy, loses to Terrence Crawford, badly, got beat up by Terrence Crawford, but Terrence Crawford is the number one pound-for-pound fighter in the world. He is. Anybody else they have up there is a problem. That's why I always say, make your own pound-for-pound list. Because don't listen to anybody, you know, about their pound-for-pound list. Because they are definitely biased. And they do what they want to do on the pound-for-pound list. They want certain people to be up there. They're going to be. And see, people like Jeff Horn are different. You know, like you guys know there's a pattern to the things I say and the things that I don't like or I might have issue with. And that's the people who are exalted high in pound-for-pound list or supposed to be generally better, have the most fans and all that. And then they don't have to fight mandatories. They don't have to try to unify the division. They cannot fight other fighters that are in their division, that want to fight them, that are pertinent, relevant, and that deserve these fights. And they don't have to. And people see them not doing things. Fighting smaller guys and things like that, right? But they can still be up on the pound-for-pound list above the guys that are there, that are deserving. Jeff Horn is not of this cloth, right? He's after fighting Manny Pacquiao, he at least mentioned as a welterweight Errol Spence. He mentioned him like, hey, I'll fight Errol Spence. When the others weren't at all, you have to register things like that. And these so-called pound-for-pound lists, they don't dock points. For, hey, you don't want to fight a mandatory? Okay, you move down on the list. We registered that, right? Or, you know, this guy, you don't want to unify. You don't want to fight mandatories. You move down because the people that are making these pound-for-pound lists, they have all the inside information, but they don't present it to you. So because this guy can be up here because maybe he might make more money or he looks this way. It's better that, you know, hey, our demographic would rather have him up there. This is what this is all about. That's why please make your own list, right? After if you're into boxing like that. Because you would know, right? You have enough information. When you come check out people like Doma, he'll let you know. Because he's not going to favor others over others. It's about being fair, period. And Jeff Horn will fight anybody. And now that he's won and he had up to this catch weight, he's thinking, well, I could fight at 147, I could fight at 154, I can even fight at 160. Probably shouldn't do that yet, but 154. So expect this guy to be in some good fights and register what he has done, right, up until now. Register what he has done because he's going to be in some fights because here's another thing. he's like, well, if Terrence Crawford come to Australia, I'll rematch him. You know what I mean? He's not trying to say, well, because Terrence Crawford beat the hell out of me, I don't want to have to deal with him no more. No, come here, I'll try it again. And this is the kind of thing that Jeff Horn does. Now, people can ignore that, but the guys that you like, right, are they doing these kind of things? Ask yourself that, right? We got these middleweights. I'm not mentioning the name today, but these middleweights, this mad exodus from middleweights, from people who were saying they want a unified middleweight division, people who are now considered to be the best middleweight without having to fight with one of them, one middleweight. Now, he's better than all the ones that are there, that are mandatories, and have belts, right? Proven guys waiting in wings. These things are ridiculous. We got heavyweights that, hey, we, you know what? We could have had one heavyweight champion in September. We could have one heavyweight champion, and everybody gets in line and fight. This heavyweight can fight one person, you know, his mandatories after that, right? And we got one unified heavyweight champion, he fights mandatories after that. We're not having that. Because you know why? Fans are like, hey, well, wait a minute. This guy can make this. Fans are accountants now. Right? You know, hey, he can make more money doing this. Oh, wait, he doesn't have to make over here and fight for this much money because you know what? It'll take him 3 fights to make it this way, but hey, it's less risk. Fans are promoters now. You know, it's like the fans are supposed to be like, look, can we have one champion in all in every weight division? Fans don't even want it because I've counted the weight, the champions we have, guys. I've told you if you say champion and you're in a big auditorium full of people, a whole bunch of people, and you say, hey, champ, stand up. Everybody except you is standing up because we have 4 sanctioned bodies, about to be 6 sanctioned bodies in 17 weight divisions, guys. Right? Do the math. There's hundreds of champions running around here now. And it behooves us as fans to say, you know what? We all want one per division. There's enough divisions as it is. It's not like it used to be, hey, lightweight, then we welterweight. Well, all this stuff in between now. You know what I'm saying? Welterweight. Shoot, middleweight. Now all this stuff in between. We got juniors and supers and all kind of stuff. So since we have that, is it too much to ask to have one champion? Right? But because fans like, hey, well, shoot, I like the way this guy look. He comes from my country. Or, ooh, he looks like me. Oh, well, I don't want him to fight this guy. He's too dangerous. Because we're doing that, they keep feeding it to us. So when you see a Jeff Horn, it's a breath of fresh air. There's something different there. He's 30 years old, and he's trying to prove things. And it's obvious. He's not going to be sitting here trying to fight easy fights. And for me, I'm loving it. So props and respect to Jeff Horn. Let's see what he does in the future. But, hey, let him enjoy this mundane win. But watch. He will be willing to fight some people. And then the guys around him won't be. So all hail Jeff Horn, period. Doma Sports Talk. Worldwide. I'm about here, y'all.